It's no Dr. Seuss.
This seems to really portray marijuana in a very positive way, and it is a children's book.
A kid's story tackling an adult topic.
We're talking about an illustrated children's book all about marijuana.
On your side, an investigator, Anna Song, talked to the author about what in the world he was thinking. What did he say, Anna?
Well, he has his reasons. We'll get to those in just a moment, Steve and Deb. But the book is called It's Just a Plant. It's colorful, it has an interesting storyline, and it doesn't exactly make marijuana out to be a bad thing.
The story begins like so many other children's tales. Little Jackie wakes up in the middle of the night, but right away it takes a turn. Jackie smells something sweet in the air and walks down the hall to her parents' room, where she finds Mommy and Daddy, well, lighting up.
Are you and Daddy smoking a cigarette? No, baby, said her mother. This is a, quote, joint. It's made of marijuana.
We follow Jackie's adventure with her mom, in which the child talks to a variety of people about marijuana. They include some guys on the street who tell her all the different names for it, and the police officer who arrests the same guys for smoking it.
She also talks to a farmer who tells her marijuana is a flower and has different effects on people who try it. Writers, scientists, even presidents.
Yes, even the ones who claim they didn't inhale.
Encounters.
We showed the book to parents outside a Southeast Portland elementary school. Their reactions ranged from shock.
Oh my goodness, marijuana?
Mm-hmm.
It's no good.
Just is more information than I think a young child needs. And not really an appropriate way to approach the subject with a child.
To support.
I went to graduate school in Amsterdam, and so I think their approach to tolerance towards marijuana is definitely a more sophisticated and just approach.
And as you might imagine, parents marching in Portland's Million Marijuana March Saturday, many of whom support legalizing the drug. We're huge fans.
I do. She reads it. She likes it.
We notice this woman carrying her own copy.
Why do you like this book?
This book is awesome. It lays it out.
I like it. It explains a lot of stuff, and it can help the kids understand that that marijuana helps people.
We should be doing better than the DARE program, and that's a big dream of mine because I was the president of the PTA and a stoner at the same time.
The author of It's Just a Plant, Ricardo Cordes, says after working in public schools and in drug policy, he felt there needed to be a new way to talk with children about marijuana.
This book is not about teaching kids how to use marijuana. It's quite the opposite. It's really about educating them about the plant.
This is a book for children.
Drug preventionist Eric Martin agrees improvements are needed in programs intended to keep kids off drugs. But he says some of the most successful drug prevention methods don't even talk about specific substances and their effects. Instead, they promote healthy activities, like reading.
We have research to suggest that there are other strategies that are more effective than just simply scare tactics and telling kids that drugs are bad. But I don't know if this is one of those models.
And the author does say that he self-published the book. He didn't find a publisher who was willing to touch it. It was just too controversial. And it is only available on the internet.
President of the PTA and a stoner at the same time. What's the next book? I'm afraid to ask.
It's actually quite interesting. His next book is called I Won't Blow You Up, and it's to address discrimination against people of Middle Eastern descent. So he certainly likes to take on these curious topics with kids.
Lightly. Anna, yeah. Thank you.